Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Early season, mid-season, late season, it really doesn't matter. The SEC doesn't wait to turn up the intensity. An early season matchup in the Southeastern Conference. That's going to do it for us. Thanks for checking out the pregame show. NCAA college football action coming right at you. Brad and Kirk on the call. David and I are back at halftime.
Located here in the heart of Dixie, Auburn, Alabama, and we've got a great game coming your way. Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Blankenship is lined up to kick this one off, and you can feel the thunder in the crowd as they await the start of this game. He's to the 20, and down he goes at the 26. The Gators have shown over the course of the season that they want to get this guy the football, but you can't just go to him every play.
Well, on the road, you especially want to take the crowd out of the game, and the one guy you know who can do it is this wide receiver. The problem you have is this defense, more often than not, is going to be aligned to take him out of the game. And that, to your point, Brad, that's where somebody's going to have to step up, whether it's the running game, some of the other receivers. You're going to have to take some of the pressure off of him and really make it a team effort to be able to win this game on the road.
Pretty nice pickup here. These guys are getting very tight on their timing.
From their own 32-yard line, it's second down. Fires complete over the middle, and he's tackled at the 41. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
And he's level at the 34.
The protection broke down. The defense was in the backfield in a hurry, and they brought the quarterback down. Nice play.
Find themselves in a hole here after that sack at second and long. Brought down right around the 44-yard line.
What impresses me so much is the guy's vision. He read the coverage perfectly to find his man for good yardage.
Incomplete, trying to get it to his receiver. Kelly was the intended target, so that'll make it fourth down.
On third down, the defense was expecting the pass, and they defended the play very well in the secondary.
Kemp is the punter. He dropped it.
Well, that's exactly what happens when you take your eyes off the ball. Concentration for a return man is of the utmost importance.
That return man is lucky that his team got the ball back, or he would have heard an earful from the coach. Actually, he probably will anyway. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Trying to get it to the tight end, but it falls to the ground.
Well, that was clearly a poor read on somebody's part. And the bad news is there was no defender around. If the pass was anywhere near him, it could have gone for a big play.
It's second and 10. All on their own 26. Caught it, but they're going to lose yards. He was tackled immediately.
Barrett takes him down for a loss behind the line at the 23-yard line. Third down.
had it intercepted.
Nunez breaks up the pass. That'll bring up fourth and 13.
Turner is waiting for the snap. They'll bring him down at the 41-yard line. Auburn's defense got the stop they wanted on that first drive. Now let's see if they can do it again.
And just listen to this crowd, Brad. I mean, you can practically feel the energy coming down from the crowd and how it's impacting these players.
They've got to play with some focus and smarts here. They don't want to make a mistake and suddenly find themselves trailing. They run straight, brought down quickly. From the 41-yard line, second down. Gets out to around the 32.
That's a deep down the way. That'll make it third and one.
Jordan will try the left side. Good outside run there.
First down.
First and 10. Ball on the 28. He's tackled at the 25-yard line. Push him out at the 16. So another run and another first down.
Now it's time for the defense to buckle down. They need to start hitting the gaps and getting into the backfield.
From the 16-yard line, first down. Quick strike to the receiver. And he's taken down around the 4-yard line.
This receiving corps runs some great routes, and that last play was an example of that. As a defender, it can be tough to match up sometimes.
Touchdown, Gators! Converts the extra point. A 7-play, 41-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear your heart out. That can really demoralize the defense when they drive the ball down the field, and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
Florida to kick from the 7. Oh, man, did he take a hit. And while they are behind, they know they can knock things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Makes it out to about the 39. Taken down at the 40-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 1 yard. That brings up second and 9.
He's scrambling. He knows how to run.
It's always a snap decision when you decide to tuck it and run. On that play, it was definitely the right move as he got the first down after a nice game.
Got a man, watch out here. And they make the stop right around the 20.
Yeah.
runs it and tackled in the backfield.
That's a loss of 3 yards on the play. That'll bring up second and 12.
So at the end of the quarter, Florida leads 7-0. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. Complete, brought down, nothing doing. Get to that quickly. The 5. Touchdown, Tigers.
Well, it's all about the receiver on this play. He beat his man off the line and then ran a perfect route. All he had to do after that was make the catch.
We'll be tied with the extra point. He splits the uprights with the extra point. So a 7-play, 75-yard drive, and they get it in for 7.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
Auburn is lining up to kick this one off. He's to the 20. They've been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to open it up a little bit more now. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Jordan gains around 6 yards on the run.
That'll bring up second and 3.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Made at the 34-yard line. Berg is the kind of player that keeps defensive coordinators up late at night, Herbie. I mean, if you load the box and take away the run, he's going to go up on top. If you sit back in the zone, he'll kill you with his legs. I mean, he's a great player. Short yardage situation here. It's 3rd and 1. Jumped out of bounds at the 32-yard line. Sullivan will be the return man. He makes it to the 38-yard line. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. Tackle at the 46.
What we're seeing right now is just a great connection between the quarterback and his receivers. They make these plays look effortless.
It to the 45-yard line.
Gain 1 yard. That brings up second and 9.
Four down, four down. My 50.
Here we go. Nice run up the middle.
That's a gain of 4 on one play. That'll make it 3rd and 5.
Tight end right. Four down, four down. Hey, check my 50. Ready. Ready.
moves up in the pocket. Quick throw to the back. It's incomplete.
The pass is incomplete. Holland was the intended receiver on the play. That'll bring up fourth and five.
He'll try to change the field position and especially not get it to the end zone. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. He's knocked out of bounds at the 31.
That's good for a gain of 11 yards. That makes it first and 10.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 31. Here's the handoff, and he's taken down for a loss.
That makes it second and 10.
The Gators taking their first time out of the half. To the 40. There's a strike complete. And down he goes around the 43-yard line.
First down.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43-yard line. And he tackles him hard at the 40. Here's a quick throw.
That makes it second and 10.
From the 40-yard line, it's second down.
Here we go.
Stays in bounds to make a nice catch.
That makes it first and 10.
Fires out to his wideout. They'll bring him down at the 16-yard line.
I think it was a great play call, and it was very well executed. Any coach would be happy with that kind of outcome on a first or second down play.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go.
Ready! Green 19! Green!
With the pass, incomplete. And this is the ninth play of the current drive. Caught, open field. He's out of bounds at about the 13.
First down.
From the 13-yard line, it's first down. He gets to about the 5.
That's a deep. That makes it second and 2.
This is the 11th play of this drive. Fires quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown. He adds the extra point. King has the ball all teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off.
He kicks it off, and he got all of that one.
Tries to get around the corner, and he's taken down at the 22. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Throws in the middle, and he's tackled at the 20-yard line. They're stopped 2 yards behind the line.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
From their own 20-yard line, it's second down. The Tigers' wideout out with an apparent injury, although he might make a comeback before this game's over. Throw. He's to the 40. Brought down at the 45. So at the end of the half, Florida leads 14-7. Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half.
Sends it sailing downfield.
Tackle made at the 17-yard line. The Gators continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Just throws this one away. From their own 17-yard line, second down. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. He's tackled right around the 28-yard line. Throws complete. He's got space to work. Knocked out of bounds at the 35-yard line. From their own 33-yard line, it's third down.
Three down.
Mike 50.
He scrambles. And he's taken down at about the 39-yard line. Open field tackle.
That's a gain of two on the play. That makes it second and eight.
Three down.
They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide out look. And he's knocked out immediately after the catch.
That'll bring
We're at play number 9 of this current drive. Throws it to the halfback on the screen. He's tackled in the open field.
Livingston with the tackle, the 37-yard line. That makes it 3rd and 3.
He makes his way out to about the 25. Makes his way out to about the 12.
That makes it 1st and 10.
Makes the catch, and look out. He gets hit out of bounds.
Around the 7-yard line.
Gray's the guy everyone has their eyes on right now, Kirk. And he comes with a lot of expectations. Time will only tell if he's the new hope or if he's all hype.
Carries the ball for a nice game.
Gain of 4 on the play. That'll bring up 3rd and 2.
Tight right. Four down. Mike's 50.
Sack, Green 90.
Strike to his receiver, no good.
Well, he must have hurried there because his receiver was wide open. There was no need to rush that one at all.
It's 4th down. This one should be makeable. He gets it up, and he's got it.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Bell from the 5. And they push him out at the 28.
So we're just about ready to return to action.
Florida is up by 4. Out of bounds at the 30-yard line.
Called a gain of 2 yards. That makes it 2nd and 8.
2nd down, 8 yards to go. Ball on the 30. And they make the stop
right around the 38-yard line.
Taken down right around the 40.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards. First down.
From their own 40-yard line. First down.
Check 59. Mike is 59.
Quick release. Tight end. Incomplete.
You know, sometimes the toughest throws to make for a quarterback is when he has a wide receiver wide open. And everybody in the stands is saying, throw it. And you aim the football instead of just getting back in rhythm, stepping, and throwing. And that time, he aimed the ball, and it was incomplete.
Tackle made at the 48-yard line.
3rd down.
They'll line it up again on 3rd down. Hit immediately.
Well, the idea here was obviously not to try anything tricky or force the ball down the field. A simple throw, and they got the 1st down that they needed.
Here's the 8th play of the series. Florida is up 4. Gains his way to the 39-yard line.
You know that saying, get your keys out, because we're on a drive? This offense right now is on a drive. I mean, this is their 3rd 1st down. They're doing just about anything they want, and they're really starting to wear the psyche of this defense down.
tackle around the 22-yard line. Here's play number 10 on the drive.
Hey, watch 28.
Right here, right here.
And they hit him in the backfield. So with one quarter remaining, the Gators lead 14-10. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. That's a great tackle at the 3-yard line. Fires quickly, and he's got his man.
That makes it first and goal.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Florida holds a 4-point lead. Converts the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. And he's tackled at the 28-yard line. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. Drilled to 39-yard line. Catches it, and he's looking for more. He's pushed out of bounds right around the 42-yard line.
That makes it second and six.
Takes it right and brought down right away.
No gain. Too easy. That makes it third and seven.
And he shoved out of bounds at the 49-yard line.
Hey, it's a first down for this offense that keeps everybody enthusiastic. You can see the momentum that this offense is gaining. The coaches and the players on the sideline are fired up, and hey, it's a new set of downs.
He's going to try and scramble. It out to about the 36. From the 36-yard line, first down. He gets out to about the 21-yard line.
It's great when a running attack comes through for the first down like this. It makes an offense so much more versatile.
Here we go.
He's on the run. And down he goes at the 13-yard line. Good gain there on the quarterback scramble.
You know, I really like the decision to tuck it and run here. He waited and found no one open, so instead of throwing it away, he just took it upfield for himself.
And he's level at the 11-yard line. Less than 3 minutes in the game. He's scrambling. Now he's going to run and watch out. And he tackles him hard at the 3.
That makes it 2nd and 2.
You ain't doing nothing today. You ain't doing nothing today.
Ready, check. Lighting.
Run. Touchdown, Tigers.
Coach there. Just give it to your main man anytime you're near the goal line.
Perfect job there of spreading out that defense and then going to the ground game.
Well, they're going to try for the 2-point conversion. And they get the 2.
Let's throw it out to Reese now for a studio update.
The Tigers were ranked number 13. They took care of business, and they should hold their spot next week. This game was tighter than spandex on a sumo wrestler. The Tigers take it by 5.
All right, thanks a lot, Reese.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Leach fields it at the 7. Brought down at the 27-yard line.
Here might effectively end this one. Oh, and he can't hang on. Huge drop there.
That makes it 2nd and 10.
From their own 27-yard line. 2nd down.
Taking their first time out of the half.
Just over 2 minutes in the game.
He's got it with room to run. They'll bring him down around the 39-yard line.
Impressive gain there by the Duke.
From their own 39-yard line, it's 1st down. Got him for a loss.
Super job here by the defense of filling the gaps on the line. If you keep stringing out plays like that, you can really shut an option attack down.
Runs it right and can't get away. Nice tackle. And they'll look to convert here on another 3rd down. Sullivan takes it to 15, and he's taken down at the 21.
Here's the chance. Late in the 4th quarter, they're behind, but they've got an opportunity now to come back and win it.
Under a minute left in the game.
He zips it out to the right.
Brought down right around the 48-yard line.
You know, at that point, I think, Brad, the quarterback's just better off just taking a sack. You have to be very careful as you're feeling pressure to throw the ball, just to throw the ball. If you feel like you're not going to be able to make a play and the defense got you, just give up on that play and get ready for the next down.
Quick throw, incomplete, one of his receiver.
That's a miscommunication between a quarterback and a wide receiver right there. They need to get their signal straight.
To get back in this game here in the fourth, this third and goal is vital.
He heaves it deep. He's hit and taken down.
Quarter, and the big question is, in a game this close, who's going to crack first?
And he tacks on the extra point. Be surprised if they just squib it here.
He sends this one deep.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
The Gators have sort of set up the defense with this wide receiver doing most of the damage. Do they go away from him or they do something different?
I think one of two things here for this offense. You either find a way to get your star receiver the football, or in some cases you want to use him as a decoy, maybe take two or three defenders with him, and then open it up for somebody else to be able to make a play.
Fires that quickly, incomplete. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 25-yard line. He's tackled at the 40-yard line. The Gators will use their first time out of the half.
Florida is going to have to use their second time out of the half.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 40-yard line.
Here we go, check. Hammerhead.
And he throws it away. One last play, folks. It's time to find out how far he can throw it and see if this game becomes one of the all-time greatest. Here we go.
Just a tremendous job by that defense, and their coordinator did a super job there to keep it this close in this ballgame, and now the offense has got a chance to win it.
So it's fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. Tackle just sealed the deal.
Leach has seen his name all over the headlines. He's not going to like the headlines tomorrow.
No, it just showed up a little bit flat today. And I don't know if it's complacency that set in or he just did not look like himself. The entire offense didn't look like themselves. And they're going to have to learn from this and try to move on.
That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.